Hey, everybody, it's the Polargust 5000, back with more Secret of Mana. It's been a while since I recorded those first two parts, but in this episode, we're going to head through Gaia's navel, it's looking like. I don't know which way to go. I think I got to go this way to advance further. And no, this goes outside. What's over in the other way, then? Because there's definitely another way to go here. You can come out here, can't you? No! There's nothing there. Gotta go in the other cave. I thought that area, like, down and to the right of Neko was where I came in. But this is the way forward. And this area is really long and kind of uneventful. So I'm kind of hoping I'll just be able to take it nice and easy here, because I'm, like, very low on energy right now. I think this is actually the first... No, this isn't the first video I record. How far... What you got? Excuse me. Jeez. Man, I'm not talking good all of a sudden. I started a course at a college for, like, a portfolio preparation for a course I'm planning on taking in the fall. So that's been going on, and that's pretty explosive, pretty bombastic. We got a treasure here. Pick up the treasure. Dan, eat the butterfly. 28 GP? That's pretty nice. Dude, don't copy again. Oh no, I'm poisoned. Ow! Ow, wow, 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 wow. I can't hit these guys. I can't shake this guy. Oh, you know what? I bet it would help if I used the spear. Because I have the spear that's got a little bit more damage, and it's got a little bit more range, too. Sir? I'm gonna have to ask you to take off your hockey skates. Okay. Let's not die to some fucking slimes. Let's eat a candy. Let's not cast Blink and take it out of somebody's hand and put a coin in their hand. Yeah. These slimes are actually really good for grinding, because you can just kind of fight them over and over again. Wait for them to multiply before you kill, like, the last one. And get, like, just grind experience basically forever. But I'm not going to do that because I don't really want to. Because that shit takes forever. Wow, look at these rupees. Oh, careful. These guys with the axes will be sleeping when you see them. But they'll wake up if you come near them, and they get a lot, like, they're rowdy. They're crazy. They're crazy men. They're crazy, like, kobold things. I'm not even sure what these are. I want to say kobold. Like, that's what my brain tells me when I see the shape of their bodies. My brain tells me kobold. But that's probably not what they're actually called. If I could get a whacked here, like a critical hit, it would say... Oh well. They're pretty weak. If you can just combo, if you can stun lock them, they're pretty weak. Like, there's nothing to worry about. These bats are a real problem because they're fast, and I think they also have an ability called Balloon, I think, which basically freezes you in place for a really long time. Kid Goblin. Okay, they're just goblins. Da 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 da. Oh, we dropped something. In here. Poison needle. Matt, eat a dick, you know? I've never even seen that before. Oh, I can't go that way. Alright, this guy needs to get his face fucking wrecked right back inwards. Okay, or not. I guess I just can't hit him at all. Ever. Turn the volume down on my emulator a bit. Because I can barely see what the hell. I can barely hear what I'm doing. Hey, get out of here. Swing your sword, or swing your axe, or something. What game is it where there's kobolds, and then there's, like, a variant of kobold called a kobold slasher? Again? Really? Seriously? That does, like, a lot of damage, man. It's like half my... Well, it's like a fifth of my HP. Oh, boy, here we go. Oh, I know what there is here, yeah. My first playthrough, I got so confused here. I was like, what the hell do I do? But there's a little switch up in the ceiling that you couldn't see through the text box. That little thing above me, that's actually a switch that you can hit. And then when you hit it, you can come back out here to this room with all these bats that I really wish would just begouch and not cat. And don't, please don't cast a balloon on me, because I know you can. I know you have it. I'm pretty sure you have it, at least. There's three of them. Yeah, there he is. There he goes. Yeah, there you go. Now I can't move. And that shit lasts, like, for way too long. It's ridiculous. I don't know if maybe you can, like, mash buttons to get out of it, but I don't think so. Yeah, if you see him start to glow like that, try and get away from the enemies as much as you can, although it's probably not gonna help. I'm gonna use the control stick for a little bit because my thumb is literally getting tired from pushing that. Oh, I can just walk across there now. That's cool. Yeah, now he can come over here where there's nothing. But what we can actually do is come over here where there's also nothing, but there's a pit, but there's a passageway here that probably goes down. Yeah, how many times do I have to say I don't know this game? You know, you gotta listen. You gotta believe me, man. I really don't. Well, that guy does not know what the hell is going on up in the top right. I'm a little bit antsy right now because as soon as I'm finished recording this, I'm gonna go get a voice chat with Fish. And it's not that I'm particularly nervous about the voice chat. It's just I'm nervous about voice chatting in general online. It just makes me nervous. I always feel like I have to be really extra quiet when I'm not talking. Like, no breathing, you know, or like no audible breathing. It's like, jeez. Alright, quit splitting, you stoops. What's in here? Ooh. It's a secret treasure! Can I, switch to my other sword? Yeah, let's switch back to the rusty sword and actually use a super mega attack to kick this guy's ass. And then I can just switch back to the spear right away. Yeah, holy crap. Kid Goblin got whacked in dee-dee-doo. He didn't stand a ghost of a chance! That guy got whacked too. Found the magic rope! Hot diggity dog! I think that's an item that... I'm pretty sure that's basically an escape rope. Like in Pokemon.
No more yawning, man!
No excuses. You didn't, like, it's not like you slept poorly, you slept pretty dang well, I think. I don't actually remember how well I slept last night. I remember I was really happy going to sleep, but I don't remember how well I slept, and I just kind of woke up unceremoniously this morning. Like, I didn't, like, rest for a long time. Candy! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. This music is really helping, though. Like the most relaxing episode I've ever recorded. I don't know, some of those Plants vs. Zombies, those have been some pretty relaxing episodes, let me tell you what. Holy crap, 28 GP, at least it wasn't more fucking poison needles. I mean, 28 GP, you know, that's something. I've also got a really nice smoothie here. I had a smoothie earlier that was like, it was like pineapple, a mixed fruit, like mixed frozen fruit, like crushed ice, and then just like lemon yogurt. And this one is like pineapple, apple, ice, and fresh yogurt, and lemon yogurt. Man, I don't know why you can't freaking hit these slimes with anything, but seriously, it's really frustrating. Like, they get like they just dodge every fucking attack, you know? And there you go, they're just splitting. Like, no, there's gotta be at least five. Oh no, I think the other two actually despawned. It's just really frustrating, these stupid slimes, because they're so evasive. But they can freaking multiply. It's like, it's impossible to kill them. Unless you've got, like, crazy weapon skill. Don't hit me, please. No, I can't hit you, because you're perfectly diagonally for me. But if I approach you any further... Ugh. What the hell hit me there? And why did it do 30 fucking damage? Yeah, like, these guys are seriously dangerous. I'm not hanging around there anymore. That's dangerous. Is there a way to go... right here? I didn't see one. Unless I can just walk on that somewhere. Oh, I can just walk across that. I thought those were rocks, like the kind you'd see in Secret of Evermore. I'd have to destroy with the axe. I think that's in this game too, actually. Okay, what's to the left there? I'm too curious. Get fucking go away, seriously? Oh, shit. Okay. I need to eat a candy. Because I just suck that much at this game, and they're gonna approach me while I'm eating this fucking candy, and then they're gonna hit me again. No, they aren't. Okay, just step away from them. Don't push the right button. Okay, let's just get these guys out of here. Yeah, just get away from me. Get away from me. Get away from me. Yeah, there you go. Never thought of doing that before. Oh, I can't even get through there because there's no... Because I can't get through those stalagmites. I think you need the axe to do that, actually. Where is this? I think we're actually almost done here. Like, we're almost at the next... We're almost at the end of this cave. We might actually get the next boss in this video. What's in here? Poison needles! 28 GP. Are those just, like, the only two things that those guys can drop? Like, 28 GP and poison needles? I love that. Okay, this is here. Oh, okay, that makes sense. And then you can come back down here, and the music changes to this really annoying song called It Happened Late One Evening. And we are now in the Dwarf Town, which is really cool. You can hear rumblings from somewhere even deeper than from the near. Sounds like digging. Yeah. I am not interested in talking to everybody in this town right now.
I want to get to this boss fight and be done with it. This is the...
This is why we came down here in the first place. The blacksmith. We needed to find the blacksmith because he didn't know where the blacksmith was. But holy crap, what the hell? Say, show me that sword. It's coming in rust and it'll break in no time. I am Watts, the blacksmith. I'll reforge it for 100 GP. Yeah, please do. Thank you. What is wrong with your... Are you supposed to look like that? Right, wait a sec. My voice changed all of a sudden. Now I sound like Cid from Final Fantasy IV. It's done. I've never seen a sword as fine as this one in my life.
What's the neck? I'm working with this splendid sword. Oh, what on earth? My hammer was harder to glow. Oh my gosh, that must be the Mana Sword!
Astonishing, perhaps the power of the Mana Sword has seeped into my hammer.
I'm gonna try to make an axe of this. Come back in a while.
Yeah, now we got a better sword. I think, I guess. Yeah. A broadsword. We got 27 power instead of the meager 22 that it had when it was a rusty sword. And over here, this area is blocked off, but that'll actually lead up back up into the overworld, I think. What is that? Is he supposed to look like that? But anyway. I think if you go up here. This is like a shop. Yeah. Let's talk to the. Let's talk to the slightly less obnoxious dwarven dancing salesperson. Headgear, that sounds like something I would wear. Spiky suit is really expensive, but it also sounds like it'd probably be pretty good. I mean, honestly, I can afford all of this. Oh, hey, it does show who can equip something. Okay, well, let's buy a spiky suit. Thank you. And let's buy a power wrist. Thank you. And let's buy the headgear. Thank you. Now we can leave and equip that. Equip the headgear, which brings us from 0 defense to 7. Go from wristband to power wrist, giving us an extra 3, and go from overalls to spiky suit, giving us an extra 10! Holy shit! Now let's sell what we've got. Which is pretty much a bunch of crap, but it'll, you know... 30 GP, that's something. And then we got the overalls, which are worth 12, wow. And the rabbit cap I'm holding on to, because I think the guy, another party member can wear it. Be seeing you. Yeah, I guess I will. If you come in here, I think this is where it is. There's a guy here. What is this guy? Oh, is he like, is this like a lizard person? Ha ha ha, welcome to the Dwarf Village. What have you been next door? There are many curious things in the village. Want to take a look? No, he was just facing to the side, and he looks even weirder than Watts did. Anyway, here we are. Step right on in. It's the Dwarf Village's world-famous exhibit hut. Elder? Me? Nah, I run a show. Wanna see it? Yeah, 50 GP. Oh, that's all.
The show's just starting.
Okay. First, catch us on this rabbit man. The only one in the world. Oh, pfft. Good. Hey, you pipe down. Amazing. like an actual very rare sprite child. What?
Won't you please help me?
Yes, folks, it's pure strategy. Weep as you hear his story. This poor child has a 50,000 GP debt to pay off. Is that supposed to make me feel sorry for him? It's here, working out the debt bit by bit. I mean, I guess if you're honestly working at it, but I mean, you have to consider, okay, well, how did you get in that debt in the first place? Oh, please, gentle people. Please help it, even 100 GP will help. Yeah, fine. Oh, joy, thank you, I'll take that, thank you so much. Why did you get larger all of a sudden? Is something wrong with my game? Like, something wrong with this ROM? I'm pretty sure he's not supposed to look like a tiny man in that, like a tiny sprite in that shot there.
How was that? What an act I am. That guy wasn't even crying.
Well, I wasn't too bad myself. Ha! We're gonna make a fortune!
What?
You scum!
Hey! Did you hear what we just said? But please forgive us, this child really is a sprite child. He used to live in the sprite forest, but a flood brought it here. I thought I'd help it earn the money to return home.
Good idea, huh?
Hey, you have to apologize too.
Harumph. Okay, I was wrong.
I'm ashamed of myself. I'll return your money.
All of it. Awesome.
I love how he gives it to you in two separate payments. He pays you 100 back and then the 50 you spent for admission.
Didn't mean any harm.
Is that all you guys are gonna say? Sorry, didn't mean any harm. Okay. Bye, I guess. Oh, there's an earthquake. What on earth? Quake! Ha ha! That was almost a joke. Something's coming!
Uh-oh. Yeah, there's a boss fight here all of a sudden, like, just suddenly, cheerfully. Oh, what a crazy... what a weird... This guy is so weird. I think this guy's called Tropicalo. And he's, like, really freaky looking, like, I tell ya. 51 damage. That's more than 10, so it's a lot. And then these vines come after you all spooky, like... That's really scary. After all, Halloween is a scary. Hiya!
What?
Bop!
Get him!
Yes! Victorious!
Okay. Yeah, this fight's really easy. Unless he, like, pops up in an area where you can't get to him in time, which kind of sucks. Oh, come on. Hiya! Oh, Bob. There we go. Yeah, just don't get hit by those vines, and you'll pretty much be alright. Okay, I don't know if I can actually hit him from here, but let's try it. Hiya! I can, and I even hit his little bud. Whack.
His own.
Oh, that one came back. And now it's desynced. Oh, no. Okay. This guy should be almost dead here, though. Yeah, there he goes. No problem. Tropicalo taken down. I was trying to come up with a cooler word, but I couldn't. Yeah. I love that effect of the explosion. I wish I could sing along to that fanfare, but I'm never sure when it starts. Spear's orb? Hello, now we can actually charge up with our spear.
Thank you very much.
I didn't need your help. You didn't do anything.
Hey, sorry about that. This child received a shock from drifting here. It lost all its memories.
It really is a nice child. It plays tricks on people sometimes, though.
Come on, old-timer, give me a break. Take it easy.
Tropicalo broke out of a sealed palace. There must be a way into it. Your memory might return if you receive some power from the mana seed.
What? Really? I'll go now, right now!
Not alone. The palace was buried. There must be tons of monsters by now. Would you be so kind as to accompany this sprite to the palace?
Yeah, I suppose.
What luck! Did you hear that little one?
Yeah, he showing up did.
I have to talk to him?
Okay.
Hey, brother!
Brother? My name is Yori!
Okay, say why don't you name me too? That'll make it easier on you.
Please name this little sprite. This guy's name is going to be, Sparks. Does it have a Z? I don't think so. Sparks, that'll do.
Sparks? What kind of name is that? Like, nice to meet you.
Sparks joined the party!
Awesome. Now we've got another party member. And he's level 1. He's got a boomerang. Well, I think they're, like... I think they're like agender because they're like a ghostly, they're like a fairy sprite or something. But I don't know, whatever. Is there a way I can get out of here? I couldn't seem to make it through there. Hello?
Good luck, you can get to the palace, but we have a hole over there. But there is a lava field which Eleni made to seal the palace. First, go to Eleni's castle to ask her to dissolve the seal. Eleni used to be a good witch, but she's not anymore. Go north to the forest finder castle and ask her to open the seal. Yeah, okay. Here's bow and arrows you found along with the little one. Take them. Receive Chobin's bow and arrows. Excellent. That reminds me, what's the blacksmith looking? What's looking for you? Visit his workshop. What does Watts the blacksmith have for us? Find out next time on Secret of Mana. Bye, guys. Hope you enjoyed this lackadaisical episode. Whatever.